Hello everyone, welcome to Organolysis. So this is our rearrangement reaction part 11. We already made 10 videos on rearrangement reaction, different types of rearrangement reaction topic. And if you haven't checked that video, go and watch that video first. And in this video, we are going to learn about the 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. Okay, so this is very much important for CSI and NET and GATE, and the question frequently asked from this topic. Okay, so I will cover first the rearrangement and the mechanism, then we will move on to the examples or different kinds of examples or problems, right? Now let's start the video. That the first topic is the 2-3 sigma tropic. Now what kind of substrate undergo? Now we all know we have an idea then how the 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement takes place. Now there is a similar mechanism is follows, but tricky part is of this reaction is the transition state, and you have to predict the stereochemistry as well. Okay, so see that if you have this kind of substrate, then you have to first identify the number, or you have to first numbering this compound. So at first you have to number. Now how to numbering of this compound? Now see that this is your, this X is your heteroatom. Now if you have to know that if this is 1, now this is your 2, and if this is 1 and this is 1, 2, and 3, and we have an idea that how 3-3 sigma tropic reaction takes place, that there is a bond formation between 3 and 3 numbering carbon bond or any kind of hetero bond, and the bond breaking there, bond breaking between 1 and 1-1 bond. Okay, so first see that if you have this 1-2 over here and 1-2-3 over here, now there is a possibility of bond breaking between this 1-1, and there is a bond formation between 2-3, and that is how this reaction takes place, and it is called a 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. Now see these bonds, this have an electron pair, it lone pair of electron, it will attack over here, these bonds can go here and this will go here. Okay, now there is a bond formation between 2-3. How? This is your 2, this is your 3, 2 and 1, and this is your 1. See that there is a bond formation between 2 and 3. So that is what is called the 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. Now you have to know some key point of this 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement reaction, that if you have this X part like this, I'm marking over here, that if this X heteroatom, if the X heteroatom is either sulfur or nitrogen, then it is called 2-3 Stevens rearrangement. Okay, so then it is called 2-3 Stevens rearrangement. Now if this X or the heteroatom X is the oxygen, that is specifically it is oxygen, then it is called 2-3 Wittig rearrangement. We will discuss both of them, right? Now one more thing, this is your two key points. Now the next important and next most important key point of this reaction, that is called this, it is going to be superficially in nature, and it is also stereoselective. So this point is very much important, that is stereoselective. This whole 2-3 sigma tropic reaction depends on the stereoselectivity of this reaction. Okay, and the last and final but not the least is that it is follow the envelope like transition state. Okay, so it will follow envelope like transition state. Now let's see the mechanism first and how the mechanism takes place. Now if you have this E kind of isomer, that E isomer means it is trans in nature, that is why it is called E isomer. And if this E isomer is there, and it will form, you have an anion over here, you can generate anion by using a base, a strong base like butyl lithium or LDA like this. Now if you have a negative charge over here, now there is 1-2 and this is 1-2 and 3. Now this 2-3 bond formation takes place, this bonds go over here like this way. Okay, so this is how you will get this kind of product, but you have to know this kind of envelope like transition state. So this is your transition state, that you can see over here, that this R group and this R group in this way, that this is basically called this, if you know this concept of cyclohexane, then you can easily predict that this is your equatorial, and not, this is not direct equatorial, just because of it is not follow the chair formation like transition state, so that is why it is called pseudo equatorial. Okay, so this is called pseudo equatorial, and this is your pseudo equatorial. Okay, so that is why this is your it is pseudo equatorial position, and if you have this kind of transition state, and then you will get this kind of product, and it is basically called 3O isomer or the trans isomer. This OH and R group is trans to each other, and this is a important that if you have this E isomer, then you will get 3O isomer or the trans variant. Okay, so you will get the trans variant. If you have similarly, if you have the Z isomer over here, then you will find that this negative charge over here, this is 1 and 2, and this is 1, 2, and 3. There is a bond formation between in this way, and you are getting this kind of envelope. So this is also an envelope like transition state, and you will find this erythroisomer. And how this erythroisomer takes place, you can see over here that this R group is in pseudo axial and this R prime is in pseudo equatorial. And if you see if there is a bond breaking between this position, then you will get this kind of cis isomer. Okay, so this is your cis variant or erythroisomer. Now there is a important concept or the exception is that of this reaction is important for you. That is, the if you have the anion stabilizing group like an acyl group or a carbonyl acyl group like carbonyl or oxazoline type ring, then if you have ELI leak ether, that is basically this one E or Z, if you have now, then if you have this ELI leak ether, then you will get stereoisomer. Okay, so this is what is called stereo selectivity of this reaction. Stereo selectivity. So this is your stereo selectivity, right? Now if you have ELI leak ether, then you will find the syn diastereomer is a major one, and if you have Z ELI leak ether, you will find the anti diastereomer in the major form. Okay, so the concept of this part is, if you have the anion stabilizing group, note that point is very much important, that this anion stabilizing group you have to put on the system. Now what kind of anion stabilizing group, like carbonyl or any kind of oxazoline type of ring, I will show you the both of them, carbonyl and oxazoline type of ring. Then you have, then if you have the E isomer of this of the allylic ether, E kind of allylic ether, then you will find the zinc. And if you have Z, then you have the anti diastereomer. Now here you can say that there is no such anion stabilizing group like carbonyl or oxazoline, so that then there is a formation of this Z to erythro or cis and E to trans. But here the E from, if you have the anion stabilizing group, then E isomer will give syn and Z isomer will trans. And let us see how and why this reaction takes place and how the, why this is so. So if you see that this kind of transition state, that is your envelope like transition state, if you have these two group over here and you have this G group, so G group is nothing but your hydrocarbon type of intermediate, or if you have the G group is your stabilizing group, if this G group is hydrocarbon like this one, if this is a, this is what your hydrocarbon, there is a no such anion stabilizing group. If the G group is hydrocarbon kind of derivative, then you will find that there is a trans kind of from E isomer or E allylic ether, you will find that 3O isomer or trans isomer like this, that as we seen earlier. But if you have, that is it, and this is your exo orientation. Why this exo orientation? Just because of, if you have this bridging, if you see considered as a bridging group, and the bridging group is in is opposite to this G group, that is what it is called exo. And if this G group is a similar or same side to this bridged position, then it will be called the endo orientation, right? Now next example is the endo orientation. If you have this in endo orientation of the G group, then if the G group is acyl one, and acyl one, it may be carbonyl or it may be oxazoline, that is ring stabilizing group, then you will find that this kind of derivative or this kind of cis product, if cis or syn product, is basically called syn product, you will get the major one. So okay, so this is what is the overall concept. Now see some one example of it, that if you have this kind of group, this kind of substrate, you can see that this is your Z1. Now if the Z1, and if you put this butyl lithium over here, then we will of course predict that the here we acidic hydrogen is here, and this butyl lithium takes a proton, takes this hydrogen over here, and there is a formation of negative charge. Okay, so this is your negative charge. Now this negative charge will migrate over here, and there is a possibility of 2,3 sigma tropic reaction. Now see that the major product is your syn. Okay, so this is your syn, this is your 97%, and this is your 3%, that is the trans variant. Now see from the Z alkene and Z alkene, you will get the cis product. Now see Why this is cis product? Just because you have no anion stabilizing group, that kind of carbonyl or oxazoline. So that is why this will follow the first one, that is this concept. Okay, so the basic mechanism is followed over here. So that is why this cis product or the erythro product is basically major one. Now if you see some another example, then you can find the difference between between them. Okay, so from for this case there is no such anion stabilizing group, so that is why this is your major one, that is your syn. So syn is your major one. The next part of this reaction is that if you have this kind of substrate, okay, so if you have this kind of substrate, if you put the LDA, now this is your acidic hydrogen over here. Now it will take a proton from here, then you will get this negative charge over here. Now see that if you have negative charge over here, and if negative charge is adjacent to this oxazoline ring, so this is your basically the oxazoline ring. This ring is basically called oxazoline, right? Now if you have the oxazoline ring adjacent to this negative charge, then what will be the major product? The syn will be the major product, just because of if you have this. And one more thing, you have the E isomer over here. Now in this concept, from this concept, that if you have E alkene or E allyl ether over here, and if you have the anion stabilizing group also over here, then you can easily find and you can easily predict that your major product is this one, that is your 84%, this is your 16%. Now that is why this same product is your major amount, just because of if you have E isomer and if you have the oxazoline ring adjacent to this negative charge. That is why this reaction takes place. And I think you will easily find out the stereochemistry of this reaction. Okay, so don't be confused and don't be worried about that. Now next is that this kind of substrate, if you have this oxygen and tertiary butyl tin, this group, and if you put this, if you treat it with this N-butyl lithium, then there is a modified reaction is called, is basically called steel variant of this 2,3-Wittig rearrangement. Okay, now why is it, why it is Wittig? If you see carefully that this X, I already said that the X, if you have the heteroatom X is your oxygen, then this oxygen is, if X is your oxygen, then it will be called 2,3-sigmatropic rearrangement. Okay, now see that if you put treated with this butyl lithium with it, now there is a exchange between this tin and lithium, and you are getting this lithium, that is called basically called transmetallation. It is basically called transmetallation, and that is how you will find this Li over here. Now your rearrangement is too easy, and you can easily predict one, that is 1, 2, 1, 2, and 3. This bond so far go over here, this will go over here, it will be go over here. Now see this bond, this CH2 unit is attack over here, that is the number 8, number 3 carbon. Now if you see that this is your above the bond, above the plane, and this is also your above the plane. So that is why this reaction is called a stereoselective. So if you have this bond is in the below the plane, then the CH2OH will be formed in this position in the below the plane. So this is called stereoselectivity, selectivity of this reaction. Okay, so if it is in above the plane, then there is a formation of the CH2OH group in the below, above the plane, and if it is the below the plane, then there will be the CH2 which will move on to the below the plane, right? So this is called the steel variant of the 2,3-Wittig rearrangement. Okay, now this is Wittig because of this oxygen. Now next one is the this kind of example. If you have, now see this nitrogen is a lone pair of electron. So this nitrogen will direct, just because of if you have this reaction is a neutral medium, that is if you have this allyl bromide over here and the acetone is given, so no such base is given to you. So this nitrogen, only one option is that the nitrogen has a lone pair, it will directly attack over here. This is your SN2 prime type mechanism. You will find this kind of intermediate. So nitrogen is plus. Now the next thing is, if you have given this sodium hydride, so it's a base. Now if there is only possibility to abstract a proton from here, so this is your hydrogen, so this NaH, this is your plus, your minus, it will take a proton. You have this, takes a proton here and giving this negative charge over here. So this negative charge will go over here, this will go over here, and this is neutralized to the system, right? Now why this is so? See that if you have the NH2 MeNH2 coefficient above the plane, it should be the hydrogen in the below the plane. So if the hydrogen is in the below the plane, so the sodium hydride takes a hydrogen from the below the plane, so Me2N is in the above the plane, and that is why this group is in below the plane. So this is your final product, right? So this is very much important example. The next example is that if you have this kind of substrate, and if you have just only given this 1,3 diethyne, and how this reaction takes place, this sulfur has a lone pair, so it can directly attack over here and beer will leave from the system. So that is how you are getting this kind of intermediate. Now sulfur is now positive. Now there will be given this butyl lithium group. Now butyl lithium, what will it do? It can takes a proton from here to give a negative charge over here, so that you are getting this kind of negative charge over here. Now the important, this is your acidic, because this hydrogen is adjacent to the both the sulfur atom, so that is why this is your much more acidic comparative to this one. So that is why this, if you put butyl lithium, it will take from here, you will get the anion over here, right? Now see, if you have 20 degree temperature, it's a very quiet and low temperature. In this condition, it will move on to this 2,3 sigma tropic rearrangement. How this 2,3? See that this is your 1 and 2, and this is your 1, 2 and 3. This is a bond formation between 2,3. So that is how you will get this kind of product. See, if you have this intermediate, now you have to cut from here. And how to do this? I have to hydrolysis, but how, in what kind of condition and what reagent is being used? Is basically use this Ag2Cl2 or AgO also used, right? In presence of mercury, you will protect this one from this one to aldehyde, just because of it this 1,3 diethyne is the protected form of the aldehyde group, right? Now the next important thing is that if you have this kind of group and if you have this CH2I2, now see, you can think that this a reagent is a single Smith reagent, CH2I2 and E2ZN, and it will form this carbonoid like this, CH2 and I and ZNI. So this kind of carbonoid is basically formed. Now you may think that there is a cyclopropanation between either in this position or this position, but it is not. And why this is so? And you may know that lone pair electron has a greater reactivity compared to this pi electron. So if the lone pair electron is a greater reactivity, then this sulfur has a lone pair of electron, so it will first attack with this CH2 unit or this carbonoid unit. So if this is attack, I am written over here, that is CHIZNICH2, it will attack over here, then you will get like this kind of intermediate. This is in below the plane, ACPH, that is your CH2 is minus, because of it is not a carbene. Now after this carbene formation, you will get this CH2 minus over here, and with this is your methyl, right? Now the rest part is in this way. Now this negative charge, now see that this is your 1,2 and this is your 1,2,3, and there is a chance to get in temperature is given. So in this condition you will get this kind of product, okay? So in this case you can see that this group is in below the plane. So if this group is below the plane, then this attack also in the below the plane. So that is why this is your stereoselectivity, and you will get this kind of intermediate and this kind of product in the major amount. No such above the plane product is not traced. Okay, this is your important. Now if you have this kind of substrate over here, and if you put this any kind of copper salt. Now one more short trick of this to find out this reaction, that if you have this N2 group over here, and if you have this copper salt or any kind of rhodium salt like RH2OSC4 kind of reagent, or COTF, this kind of reagent, if you have this kind of reagent in this condition, that is N2 is given or any copper or rhodium kind of salt is given, now you can easily predict this reaction goes for the carbene formation, okay? So there is a leaving of this group, and now this double bond you can write in this way, N bond and triple bond N, right? You can write in this way. So if this leave from the system, there is a formation of carbene, Now this oxygen lone pair will attack over here. You will get this kind of negative charge over here. I mean get this kind of intermediate. In this intermediate, it is not stabilized. It's actually stabilized, but it is not. It can react. And how this reaction takes place? This is your 1, 2, and 3. This is your 1, 2. These bonds go here. This will go here. This will go over here. Okay, so this is basically positive. Now this is how you are getting this kind of product. Okay, so this is your 2,3 sigmotropic rearrangement. Now the next example, if you have this kind of group and if you have cesium fluoride or HMP and Dbu, now see, this is very much ionic. It is positive and CSF minus if negative. Now if you have say silyl group over here, the silyl has a tendency to form bonded with basic much bonded bond tendency to form with fluorine. Now it will attack over here. It will go over here. So you are getting this CH2 minus in this position. Now there is a chance the formation between of this, that is 2,3 sigmotropic. And how this is so? That is, this one go over here and this will go over here. Okay, you are getting this kind of intermediate, but this intermediate is not no such stability because of it will it is aromatic in nature and it will de-aromatize. So it will get back it will try to get its aromaticity back. So that is why this hydrogen will move from here and it will go here, and you are getting this kind of final product like this. Now the next and important, that is very much important reaction, is that if you have this butyl lithium. One more thing, how can you introduce that methyl group in this position, keep this overall group is intact. And if you want to introduce this methyl group over here, then how, what can be done and how this reaction proceeds? See, now if you have to put butyl lithium, so if you put butyl lithium, there is acidic hydrogen over here, now after that it will form this O minus, this kind of O minus, and this O minus is attack over PHC and Cl will leave from the system. So that is how you are getting this kind of intermediate. Now the next important thing is that this sulfur has a lone pair. Now there is a chance between 2,3 sigmotropic reaction, that is this one and this way, right? So you are getting this after the 2,3 sigmotropic reaction, you are getting this intermediate. Now if you put LDA, then what will be the acidic hydrogen? This is your acidic hydrogen. This LDA takes a proton from here and you will get negative charge over here. Now this negative charge will react with methyl iodide in this manner. So you are getting this methyl group over here. Now there is one more possibility, is that these bonds go over here, this will go here and this will go here. This is another 2,3 sigmotropic reaction and you will getting this kind of intermediate. That is methyl group over here, this is your O, this is your SPH. Now you have to remove this SPH, and how to remove this SPH? You have to put this POMe3 in presence of methanol. This reagent is basically cleaved from it in the final, that is this one. Now the see the mechanism and how this from how to get from this one to ultimate this product, how to deprotect it, like. Now this, see the mechanism, that POMe3, I am writing this overall group as R and this OSPH. Now this phosphorus is tendency to bond with sulfur or oxygen. If we so this lone pair will attack over the sulfur and this bond is over here. If it is like that, then you are getting this RO minus over here and P and SPH. So this negative charge finally takes a proton from methanol, so you are getting this ROH. This is basic, so much basic reaction. Okay, now see the last example of this overall 2,3 sigmotropic reaction is this one, that is H2O2. If you have this given substrate and in presence of H2O2, so I already said that lone pair has a greater reactivity, so it will first react with H2O2 to form this N oxide. Okay, now if you put this in 40 degree temperature, then there is a possibility of this 2,3 sigmotropic reaction. Okay, 1, 2, 3, like how this will go here, this will go here, this will go here. So you are getting this intermediate. Then this kind of intermediate is basically, this kind of rearrangement is basically called 2,3 Meisenheimer rearrangement. Okay, so this is your 2,3 Meisenheimer rearrangement. Now you are getting this intermediate, so you have to deprotect from here. So what can be done? Now zinc acetic acid is, if you put zinc acetic acid in presence of ultrasound, you are getting this bond cleavage over here, you are getting this kind of intermediate, and it is kind of final product. Okay, so this is your overall 2-3 sigma tropic reaction. Okay, so I think you have done with all these 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement, and I already covered. I am trying to cover all those reaction related to this 2-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. And if you find this video useful, share it with your friends and as much as you can. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. Okay, and press the bell icon to get earlier notification. And that's it for this video. And thank you so much for watching.